All right, we're going to get into our grand final here for our League of Legends tournament. Again, Gamer Dads versus T2 Team 2. You ready, Jacob?
I'm so ready. We have waited all day for this. It's going to be the best of the best. These teams have won both games to get to here. And we're going to finally see who is the best at League of Legends.
All right, as we load on into the champion select, Aurelia being banned out immediately.
Yep, that's definitely something that GDADS does not want to see.
I think it was somewhere around like 14 and 2 was the end score. It was just incredible how well that was played. Again, Sona getting banned out here right away.
Yeah, definitely had some impact on those games. Alright, Aurelia and Zac, they're both out.
So Zac getting banned out again.
Lucian, that's also another meaningful ban here. Because he did pretty good on his games. And finally the Vladimir. Yasuo, okay. Yasuo, that was a very important ban against
No, that was really good. I'm glad that they realized exactly that the Yasuo was a problem. And actually, even taking away the Volibear.
Oh my goodness.
Again, these picks, I've heard that they actually strategized. Both teams have actually taken into account some picks here.
Yeah, I think both teams have been able to look at each other play, see what their strengths are. I think this is going to be definitely a game where tactics finally comes into play. Before, teams came in, they didn't know who they were playing against, they didn't know who they were playing with in some situations, but now they've already meshed as a team, and now they get to go against real rivals.
Alright, so we're going to quickly go over the positions. There is going to be Harris up in the top lane. In jungle, you have Opaka. In the mid lane, Kleber Good. And as ADC, Mr. Spooky. And on support, Baby Dolls.
Alright, I'm unsure what... are they in order? All right, perfect. Then in the top lane, we got Slicer 994. In the jungle, we got Eggies. Bringing down the mid lane, we got Gormagalis. And at the ADC, it's Mr. Jared. And supporting them is, of course, Leaping Lizard 14.
Now, they could easily turn this around on us, knowing our luck. Now, interesting enough, Mr. Spooky, if he's going to go through and actually play that Vayne, again, that'll be the first Vayne we've seen, and we also see the Vel'Koz coming out.
So this will be the first Sejuani we see as well on the red side. I'm liking the Braum pick because Leaping Lizard was leaping all around when he had the Braum, doing very good standing in the front of the way of Thresh hooks, being able to block things with the shield. Definitely something that he's shown to be very good at.
And we're going Freljord comp right now. We got Braum, Sejuani, Zeref, and Ashe. Again, they're pretty blue right now, but they're on the red side.
Hopefully they'll be feeling pretty happy after this game if they win it.
Yeah, going back, Mr. Jared did a really nice job on Ashe, played her really well, used her pretty good in her utility-style role. Now, interesting enough, we see the hover. Soraka gets locked in. There is a hover on Malphite. It's going to go through even though Yasuo wasn't locked in and was banned. Meanwhile, we do have a Poppy hover at the moment. Would be a nice compliment to the team, but I have a feeling that they might not have enough damage. Again, it depends on how big Zerath and Ashe can get in this comp if they decide to go with Barb and Poppy.
Yeah, if we're looking at Poppy here, she's not going to be able to stop the Volibear from charging in at all.
Ooh, the Darius. That was banned, if I recall, actually, against them. And it's being hovered.
That one. Yes,
and honestly, against the Malphite, I think Darius, as long as he can stick to him, he should win those trades, and he will win it convincingly. It gets locked in. We're going to see some dunks happen.
Yeah, no, Darius is definitely a champion that can abuse his lane opponent and get lots of kills there.
Alrighty then. So it's going to be interesting to see exactly how this is going to play out. I'll be honest, they now have a lot of damage on red side. Darius, he gets tanky and he's able to output as much damage once he starts to get the stack supply. And that's going to be really scary to see once he gets into it.
Looking at the blue side though, nothing is stopping this team from diving into the Ashe, from diving into the Zerath. Unless Braum can successfully shield anything, but I mean, he's not going to be blocking the enemy projectile Malphite if he gets anywhere.
Yeah, no, Malphite, he doesn't care about your wall. He will go right on through it.
I mean, at this point, we're looking at Braum to try to slow down the enemy advance. We're looking at Ashe to use her ultimate in defense if she has to. I mean, the only thing that they have in terms of area of effect CC is Sejuani, so she's going to have to be on point with her ultimate.
I'm interested to see if we have any style of invade coming out of the red side. Again, you do have that Sejuani charge that, again, it's not usually what you level first off, but if you want to be aggressive, you can easily put a point into that, get a couple flashes. On the other flip side, though, you do have a Volibear. I don't believe Volibear, though. He shouldn't be starting flip, so he'll probably start bite, if I recall correctly. Again, I'm not a Volibear player.
Bite's very strong in the jungle there, especially in terms of clear speed.
All right. I'm also interested to see how well Mista uses the arrows, trying to make stuff happen with that ult and its utility. We saw a couple of them actually come out in the previous game. There was a couple that missed there and left, but overall was pretty good on the arrow.
Uh-huh. Yeah, even from cross-map, arrow showing up.
Now, the biggest thing I'm really interested to see is how well this Vayne pick works out. Again, you're against an Ashe. You got some range disadvantage, but you do have a Soraka with him, so he's able to really output damage and able to keep up the damage. As we are about to get into our game, at about 1:30 left onto the clock, should be interesting.
So I'm actually looking at the Vayne here on the blue side team, and I feel like with all the displacement that, Volibear can give, moving people around, Malphite, I think there's enough peel, there's enough safety for the Vayne to get in pretty close if she wants to, dealing out the damage that she needs to do, especially against the Darius and the Sejuani, because she's going to be their tank shredder.
Yeah, it depends on how grouped T2 stays together in those team fights, because if they keep apart, they should be able to go one by one in through the team fight. But at the moment, if they group together on top of a Malphite Vel'Koz ult, and then again you put down the silence area down from Soraka, it'll do really well in those fights. But that's a perfect fight you're looking for.
Yeah, and we want nothing less than perfection here for this fight, because this is the finals that we're looking at. This is everything on the line for them.
Yeah, so we are about to get into our game, guys. It's about 20 seconds onto the clock, and we will be in. Again, been a long day here.
Yep, but it's also been really exciting. I'm glad to have been here with all of you.
All right. Again, we are coming to the closing of the expo here, so hopefully we'll try and get these guys out. Hopefully we'll get a good game overall.
Yes, and as we look forward, we're going to look at getting it back into the game here.
All right, waiting on the clock right now.
So, yeah, I'm really interested to see what GDADS will do here, because it's going to be a completely different comp from Let Yasuo Carry Us.
Yeah.
Because now it's actually a lot of teamwork is going to be involved. And yes, they did set up Yasuo a lot, but now it's less pressure is going to be on the Yasuo, and everyone's going to have to step up here.
Yeah, I feel like the biggest matchup right here is actually going to be how well the top lane fares out.
Uh-huh.
If that Darius gets rolling and is able to use the TPs properly, he's going to be able to just steamroll over the team as we get into the rift. Here we go.
Soraka doesn't have a skin. I'm sad.
Oh, no skin on Soraka. Well, yeah, it's because... And Soraka is left behind.
Okay, so this Soraka is also going to go get that talisman, or Ancient Coin.
Again, Ancient Coin hopefully makes stuff happen around the map, engage for the team, start to really make stuff work.
It's the Poro Sejuani. So cute.
So Team 2 right now, looking in the river at the moment. Again, gotta be careful how well this goes. They are grouped up in a kind of weird place right now. Volibear and Soraka and them being safe, maybe being care about that invade. Should be interesting to see how well this plays out.
I don't think we've really seen any invades at all today, and it doesn't look like that's gonna change at all. Safe starts are pretty good here for both teams. They don't lose anything because for not doing it. So,
as I realized, we had no game audio. That was a little weird. All right, there we go. So again, kind of waiting to see what red side will do. It looks like they're not going to do an invade. Again, there is a ward being placed by Vel'Koz in that river brush. Being safe, making sure not to get caught out or anything, I guess, would be a safe bet. You don't want to get cheesed early on. Just waiting for this. This camera really likes this bush. I got to say, like, the cameraman just loves it.
Yeah, priority bush.
As we're waiting right now, there we go.
I'm looking at this mid lane matchup, and it's two long range casters, which is like a completely different thing from what we've seen from this mid laner here in Savap, Pierre Gid. Yeah, so we'll see how he adjusts.
All right, early on, Bane taking some damage, trying to trade back, gets that tumble, Brock in. Again, I want to see how well they can keep Bane alive. That's going to be a big indicator of how well this will go.
Yeah, especially the longer this game goes and the more tanky the enemy team becomes.
Yeah, she's going to be very vital. Because again, you don't have, you have the true damage. You have two true damage sources actually in here with the Vel'Koz on top of the Bane. Bane though a little more reliable. Again, Vel'Koz not able to dodge all of the skill shots. Again, Ashe having to play careful. They actually got level 2 before, so that's actually pretty good for GDADS. Again, keep up the pressure. That's what you want to do with Bane.
I'm looking at the top lane here, though, and Darius is able to have his way with this Malphite. He's very pushed in, but looking at this mid lane here.
And you can already see it. 12-3 in the CS right now. Really putting on the pressure. And that's pretty much what you want to do with Darius. You want to keep it up. You want to keep making them have to pay for that CS. Usually if they're going to try in and go for a CS, you want to put down a Q and make them pay for it. No corruption potion though, so again, he's going to have to not be able to, again, spam his abilities like you can when you go corrupting. Again, with Doran's Blade. Again, you can go either or. I kind of prefer corruption, I like to be aggressive. Meanwhile, Volibear is going to find the Poro.
Okay.
Again, Sejuani trying to do their best. Again, Volibear does not have any of his buffs again, but here comes Zerath. And here comes Darius. Darius going to come in, and that is not good for them. First Blood ends up going to Zerath.
Yeah, so Darius sees the call there and hops back down into the river bush. They're able to grab Volibear pretty easily.
Yeah, and again, Volibear doing that start again where he's not taking any of his buffs.
I mean,
we've seen a lot, actually.
He's going for fast clears, but I think he only cleared two camps there.
Again, cleared out the raptors, cleared out the wolves. I think he did the golems, technically. I don't remember the spawn timers on those, though. Yeah, they did, because they were at the bottom bush.
Uh-huh.
Again, three camps gets you three. Meanwhile, Vel'Koz going aggressive in the mid lane, gets stunned up here. Again, Thunderlord's proc, he's tanking minions. That's a lot of damage. Not able to geometry correctly. Not able to get around that. So the Q misses.
And we're looking at Sejuani stealing the buffs that Volibear left behind.
Again, that's a smart idea. We also do have a Mountain Drake onto the map now. Again, we're starting to see all the Mountain Drakes near the end here.
Uh-huh.
Again, we won't be seeing the Infernals. Maybe we'll get three Infernals. They gotta take the Dragon pretty quick for that.
No Clouds, though. We've only seen about the one.
It's been one Cloud Drake. Which is weird, because, you know, my games, I get 20 Cloud Drakes when I control Dragon.
They're very important, Dragons.
You can go really fast.
As a support, I love them.
Yeah, you go really fast. Alright, so Ashe having a little bit of difficulty here. Again, it's rare you see a Bane punish an Ashe like this. And you gotta take what you can. And Spooky was showing to be very capable on these ADCs. Again, Soraka kind of doing a little bait right now, trying to take it. Ashe, though, does take that Q. And Soraka heals up.
Oh, yeah, I did forget that her Q does blow people if she grabs in the middle. Just like that.
Yeah, so again, decent amount of damage coming down. Again, they're having trouble down in this bot lane, T2, but they gotta figure out a way to turn it.
Uh-huh.
Meanwhile, up top lane, Darius is continuing that pressure. Still hasn't backed yet. Doesn't have the ult available. Meanwhile, in bot lane, condemn away on the third proc, so getting a nice trade in there, making sure she can't respawn.
Yeah, no, looking at the top lane there, Darius is so oppressive there. And This bot lane is also very pokey.
Meanwhile, Ashe taking some damage here. She's got to be careful. She's on her last pop. Meanwhile, Zerath has bought in that needlessly rod, so that's a lot of damage coming in from these pokes. And Darius just has so much CS advantage. You got to be careful with your Malphite. You do not have anything. Here comes the dunk. He's actually keeping to trade. It's going to come in. There should be it. Be able to flash away. Darius is going to die for it. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, true damage coming down. Zerath is going to survive.
Now we're looking at Sejuani over in the bot lane jungle.
Yeah, so Sejuani invading right now, gonna try and make something happen. Again, we haven't seen Volibear all that often. He is pushing up in the top lane, so it's pretty safe. Gotta be careful though, as Ashe is a little low at the moment.
She does have Leaping Lizard to leap in front of her in case things get dicey. But Soraka's a champion that you can really get around Brahmin.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Malphite gonna have to go for the crystals at the moment. Meanwhile, Darius is gonna have a lot of movement speed, able to really hammer in some trades. Honestly, you just kill a minion really quick before you go in for a trade, and you'll have the movement speed that you need in order to catch him out. Actually, a very aggressive move coming out of the GDADS bot lane. Mr. Spooky and Baby Dolls moving up, trying to get a ward down here.
Yeah, what they saw was that Sejuani grabbing the Scuttle Crab, so they tried to move in and I think time that blue buff, but they managed to find the response from the team to bot lane, so they were forced to back out. And Zerath's gonna grab that blue buff.
Yeah, so overall, T2, again, with the advantage, most of it being in that top lane. So it's going to be interesting to see how well that transitions, depending on how well Vayne can get fed, or at least farm effectively, because she's going to need a lot to try and deal with this area. Meanwhile, here we go. Aggression coming out. Braum, though, able to block the auto attacks. That's going to force Ashe to go back.
Yeah, they're running out of mana for Braum to use to defend for Ashe, so they're making the right move, I think, to just back up.
All right, Zerath in that mid lane, able to clear pretty effectively. Nice Q coming out for Vel'Koz. Again, it's going to be how well this top lane goes. Malphite is not in a good spot. He's losing a lot of CS and he's being forced to.
Also, looking at the items that Darius was able to grab on top of Malphite's, he has so much more CS, he had so much more gold, so he's so much stronger in this lane.
Yeah, it's not going to be a fun time right now. Volibear is around, but honestly, if you gank a Darius at this ahead, you're looking at giving him a double kill, just how it works. He's one of the only champs in the game at the moment that it's really easy to turn around a gank in a 1v1 as long as you're smart enough to use your abilities correctly.
I've seen it happen so many times with Darius picking up those double kills. I mean, you think that you're able to get him, but he has so much.
No fight, going to take some damage, able to dodge away from the Q. Sejuani ended up spotting out Volibear there. So Volibear not able to make a move up. Sejuani making her way in toward that blue side jungle. Again, Wolf Spirit is going to pick her up. But
so
now
I'm looking at the items at the bot lane here, and Vayne elects to go with the recurve bow while Ashe gets the BF sword. So in terms of damage, I think Ashe has more on-hit damage.
Yeah, it'll get a little bit more damage. The attack speed over time will give her more sustained damage, so depending on how well they play this out. Again, though, once Ashe starts getting those items, let's see, Malphite up in that top lane just taking so much damage. There's nothing you can do at this point. The only thing you can really do, and it puts your other lanes behind, is you kind of go for a lane swap and try and at least punish the Darius for being pushed up and make him lose some farm. But he's now making a very demanding lead, 28-76.
Yeah, that is such a big difference there. I mean, even the bottom lane here, it's only up by 20 CS, but Ashe is still able to hold it up.
Oh, Zerath flashes in. Nice dodge is coming out of Vel'Koz. Vel'Koz looking to get him. True damage ticking. Not able to finish him off with 34 health.
Yeah, he didn't get last of that farm, and he's just going to back up. Sejuani can take advantage of this and take some meaningful damage over in that mid turret. Yeah, hopefully bounce that wave back. Help out Zerath.
All right, Soraka trying to zone out, get some health back from hitting Grom there. Again, still a decently close game. It's all on Darius, this advantage. So if they're able to, again, knock him out very fast, they should be able to win these fights. They're going to be having to play picks, though. It's not going to be a fun time. Again, sustained damage coming out. Big amount of chunk comes out onto Ash. Good job by Soraka and Bane there. Again, Mr. Spooky doing a good damn job in this matchup. Again, 25 CS advantage. Here he goes, again, going aggressive. Silence Field was a little too late, unfortunately. Here they try and turn it around. Again, Vayne is exposed, and here comes the Wish, able to pick him up. Again, Vayne trying to maybe make something else happen. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Vel'Koz getting ganked by Sejuani. A lot of damage going on to Zeraa. Zeraa forced to back away, and that's going to be a kill onto Sejuani.
Eggy is grabbing that last hit there. But yeah, no, Vayne is so strong there. He's able to grab those kills. Initiating that fight with her ultimate. Even though she got exhausted and she got knocked up by Braum and stunned, she was still able to get that damage. I think, yeah, recurve boat serving her very well.
And again, I like the strategy. It's a good idea. It forgives Vayne's bad decision. Meanwhile, here comes a gank. It's going to be probably a double here. Soraka at least going to go over to somebody. It's going to go over to Zeraa. Meanwhile, Vayne not in a good spot right now, doesn't have flash, is trying to make it happen. Oh. But Darius came in with the teleport. T2 really now trying to push advantage other way on other places on the map.
Yeah, it's very hard for Darius to be punished at this point. Even if he gives up some CS, he's still so far ahead. He can afford to come down here and help out his teammates. And it looks like it's going to be the first left tower.
Again, Volibear seen in his jungle. Sejuani with the red steel, and he's gonna fight this out. Again, Volibear should have passive popping here. Not in a good spot, gotta be careful. Vel'Koz gonna pick up the kill with the Q. And Malphite gonna try and get some damage down on this turret. He needs to try and make something happen, but look at this, red side. Gonna go ahead and take this Mountain Drake, get that bonus damage onto towers.
Volibear doesn't have the smite, so like, if you don't look to him,
just smite it. He's just gonna get taken down. Darius with the kill.
I wonder how, is Vayne gonna commit to this? I think not.
It'd be very dangerous for Vayne. Vayne actually starting to head up. Again, knock up is gonna come through. This is exactly what they need. Again, not able to finish the dunk. Darius goes down, and Vayne picks up the kill. That's what Vayne needs to do. She's gonna be the tank melter, and that's what's gonna kill Darius.
Yeah, it's the split second decision there. Darius is just a millisecond off from landing that ultimate, and that could have changed the fate of that team fight. The rest of his teammates might have gone in and could have changed it from being one death to maybe a whole team fight.
Now, gotta be careful. Ash does have that ult up. As we take a look at the gold, big advantages for Mr. Spooky. And a little bit of advantage mid lane for Zeraa. But Darius is the big factor here. 2,000 gold up, and that is the majority of their lead. As we take a little bit of a break here, going around, T2 needing to figure out what they want to do. They have a lot of ward coverage, so they've been really safe with their bot lane.
I feel like watching the dominant lanes here, for GDADS, it's the bottom lane, and for T2, it's Darius in the top lane, and watching them face off against each other and making these trades, with those two players going head-to-head and matching up equally, it's going to be how the rest of the teams help support them.
As we're waiting, again, damage goes down onto this mid lane tower. Vel'Koz stunned up there, Vayne gonna take a hit. Again, Vayne moving around the map. She wants to try and make stuff happen and forcing the bot lane to come up, but we do see a collapse here.
And
Volibear kind of might be getting hit off, might get chased down. Darius backs up.
Everyone's coming here.
All right, so here we go. All comes out. They're going to pick up the kill onto Soraka. Soraka getting out there. Mr. Spooky, he's still alive, but not for long. That's going to be a kill onto them. That's going to be a double kill onto Zeraa. And T2 doing what they need to do. Get these team fights down. Nice collapse coming down from Darius.
Yeah, very good focus there. They're able to get Soraka down, so she was unable to heal anyone other than with her ult. And then they go straight for the Vayne. Yeah, that's their main damage.
Ooh, big ult comes out. Big amount of damage. Malphite and Vel'Koz keeping that tower alive. And that's going to be a trade back. So able to answer for it and keep that tower standing. And that's the combo right there. And actually, we do see Malphite. He's building needlessly broad.
Alright, so he's going for like the AP damage when he goes in.
Like an AP tank build. So he's gonna have some damage on him.
No, yeah, definitely. He synergizes so well with a lot of champions, and especially with his teammates there. His ultimate, you know, combined with Velta's, like, that's the true damage you're talking about. That's the displacement.
Mm-hmm. And bot lane, Vayne gonna pick up a nice amount of farm now, extending that lead almost 30 CS up on top of the kill. And it looks like he's going for that Bork build. Again, it wasn't too common this season for Vayne to go with that. Usually you saw a Phantom Dancer rush or even a Static Shiv rush I've seen a couple times.
Right.
Meanwhile, Darius makes his way up into that top lane. Just scares Malphite out. He's having to back. He's getting a lot of damage onto the tower, though, due to the ropes. And Darius, he's been kind of half and half. He's had a couple good ones. He wasn't able to finish off a kill. So Malphite playing that safer game, he's got to try and make something happen and try and recover from this farm deficit.
I feel like if even Darius has to trade kills for deaths, it's still to his advantage because that's where the gold's going. And the more gold that Darius can get, the more tanky, the more he can carry. And I think that's really important for team two.
And red team gonna pick up that Rift Herald. It's gonna go over onto Darius. Vayne with a nice tumble there. Again, Vel'Koz is starting to get poked really hard. Again, Xerath has picked up a lot of kills on the side here. 5-0-2 has that Luden's Echo. It's gonna start really hurting. Vel'Koz gonna try and trade back. Does get that third proc off. Again, Ashe getting slowed here. This is going to be the biggest thing. It's going to be how well Vayne can do in this situation, how long they can keep her alive. We actually saw in the last team fight there that she got hit by an arrow that funneled through all her teammates, and that's what stunned her up.
Yeah, and then the initial catch from Sejuani on the Soraka made it so that it was very hard for Soraka to help her out.
Well, here we go. Axalt is going to hit onto Vayne. Not a whole lot she can do. She's going to tumble, flash out. Gonna start the kite, but Xerath with that ult, she gets stunned up right now. She's gonna go down. Xerath with the snipe. Meanwhile, Soraka, not in a good spot right now, is gonna go down here. Two Ash, there we go. 11-6. Again, Vel'Koz not in a good spot either. So again, Xerath with that nice ultimate, able to help out his team pick up Vayne. She almost was able to try and get out, but she got pretty stun locked there at the end.
Like, I know Vayne was the one that got killed, but it looked like her show dodging every which way, lasting so long, burning so many abilities from the enemy team. But yeah, she does go down.
Alright, Darius now actually proxying the farm with Vel'Koz. You gotta be careful here. As Vel'Koz, big amount of damage coming through. Nice combo. Make sure to punish him. It gets the shutdown.
Yeah, that's one way to take down Darius. Just use everything on him. True damage. That's a true damage.
Yeah, true damage, yeah. We're waiting here right now. 20 minutes, 7-11 is your score. T2 with the advantage. And we do have a Drake coming up here in about 12 seconds.
Actually, Vel'Koz is, if you look at his score, he's actually catching up
a
lot.
Yeah, he's been catching up a lot. He's actually ahead in farm and has kept up in kills and assists, only dying once. And does have that Morelos, which is going to be nice against Darius. He won't be able to sustain as much when it comes into using his Q on the team. As we look over here, it's going to be another Mountain Drake.
I mean, if we're talking about evenly matched teams, then we can look no further than these two teams in the finals. This is proving to be a very, very good match.
All right, so let's see what they can make happen. Again, T2, getting that second Mountain Drake could really open up the map if they get a nice fight in their favor.
Uh-huh.
Again, that's usually at least one or two tiers of turrets.
I mean, you want as much damage as possible for getting objectives, because we've seen a lot of games where it's decided by who gets the Baron, or it's decided by who gets the Elder Dragon. So it's definitely something you want to stack early on.
And having two Mountain Drakes as well, you're going to be able to take down those objectives later on. Again, Mountain Drake, the most effective thing you can have for Elder Dragon. As it does scale with Drakes, you do at least do the true damage. As they come in onto this mid lane tower, standing with about a sixth of a health left.
Yeah, but minions are nowhere near at this point, so it's going to be a lot of posturing around. This turret's not going down there for a while.
All right, Soraka getting hit up there. Is going to get stunned up. Able to keep herself alive. Zara forced to go away.
Yeah, that first shot just assumed that Soraka would move ahead, but he'd already stunned her.
Again, we do have a group up, and here comes Darius from the side. Vayne is going to hit him. Vayne, though, gets hit there. Got to condemn him away. It's not a good spot. Sizwani ult doesn't connect, but it doesn't matter. Darius able to get the ult off. It's trying to go underneath tower. It's going to go down here. And again, Malphite trying to do what he can do. Again, Vel'Koz still has his ult available. He's trying to... Here it comes! He's going to try and get as much of his team as he can, but he's not going to pick up anyone.
Anyone left is an ultimate there is Volibear.
They're all so low right now. Again, Volibear getting poked around a little. But other than that, it's just a one-for-one trade in the, at the end of the day.
It's red
Terry's turret has been destroyed.
Alright, so it looks like they're gonna walk around Dragon here. Actually, no, they're actually gonna back away from it. But Ward's going down for blue side. So they'll know when the dragon's being attacked.
Again, Malphite going to pick up that turret finally, and now getting a little bit more control up in that top half of the map.
Yeah, definitely will open them up for hopefully trying to get this dragon.
And right now, blue side just grouping up here. The Bork is finished on Vayne right now, but 1-4 and 2, not able to really do much with it. Here they go. Malphite not in a good spot right now. Doesn't have ult to try and get out. Darius just going to keep applying the stacks as they go in for the dive. He should be just... He might live. He did live with that. Again, with a sliver of health.
He is building armor. So that's definitely probably what saves him from that Darius.
So they got to be careful with the poke from Xerath. Again, Xerath does a chunk of damage, especially against Vayne right now. At least there is the Aegis finished off by Soraka, but again, Vayne takes another Q, and that does so much to you. It really takes you out of the fight right now. Again, Vel'Koz too. Here comes Sejuani from the side. Coming in, jumps in, ult misses, gets condemned into the wall. It doesn't matter. Here comes Ash's ult, and it's going to save Sejuani from any further danger. Unfortunate misplay there.
Alright, so they're calling for the dragon here.
I guess Sizwani not in a good spot, going to get condemned into the wall. Vayne able to dodge the Grom Q, and that's going to pick up the kill. What can they make happen with it? Again, look at top lane though. Darius keeps on pushing. Again, almost going to Flame Horizon Malphite at this point.
Actually, Malphite was forced to teleport up to the top lane. That means he no longer has a teleport if something happens later on the map. Very good play by Darius to push that there, forcing Malphite to come in and defend that turret.
All right, as we look now.
Look at the ward coverage for red team here.
Yeah, there is so many wards in that bottom half of jungle. They aren't going to be able to move around.
I mean, yeah, that's three pink wards there, so they know for sure. Like, if they fight anywhere there, they know where Vayne is.
Again, Vayne taking the poke there. Here comes Vel'Koz to try and help out. Let's see how this is going to end up here.
Oh, it's so even, this match.
Again, Darius coming from the side there, still has that teleport available. Again, second Mountain Drake for T2 if they can make it happen. 9, 12, 25 minutes on the clock.
And they're going to look for that Scuttle Crab before anything else happens in this match.
Oddly enough, the gold lead has actually shrunken a little for T2. GDADS have actually kept in line with that CS. Again, that's 50 CS on Vayne. Again, doing her best to try and keep up with Ashe. Meanwhile, there is almost 100 CS difference on top of Darius, and that's where all their gold is at the moment.
All right, so that dragon has been aggroed, so it's definitely going to be something in play here.
Okay, Vayne not in a good spot right now. Dodges the ult. Everyone doesn't get hit by it. Unfortunately, Vel'Koz not able to do anything. He's getting hit by Darius. Meanwhile, trying to run away right now. Volibear on the back line. Big kill comes out. Vel'Koz goes down, and that's going to be another kill. Here comes the stacks. Vayne, not in a good spot, is gonna go down, double kill going over, but they find Darius. And again, Volibear, not in a good spot right now, passive gets popped, it doesn't matter, triple kill coming out, it's gonna be a quadra kill for Ash.
That's also an ace for Team T2. They're free to grab this new Mountain Dragon, and they're free to defend. Hopefully they can grab that mid lane turret as well on the turnaround, because these are gonna be about 10 seconds left until someone else can come and do something about this.
All right, so second Mountain Drake comes out. And it's going to be a third Mountain Drake.
Oh my goodness. They really
need to have the dragon control here. If that third Mountain Drake comes out and they lose one team fight, that will be their base. That will be the majority, at least an in-him, maybe even Nexus turrets in a clean ace like that one.
I always used to think that a Mountain Dragon would also help you with neutral objectives like the Grump. But that is not the case.
No, only Baron.
Yes.
But again, that gives them a lot of Baron pressure now.
With two
Mountain Drakes, that's a lot of damage.
I guess if you're looking for more damage on, like, Gromp or something, then you'd grab the Infernal Dragon.
All right. So let's see. Pink Ward is cleared out by Volibear. Again, 27 minutes on the clock. 10-17 is the score. And they're trying to push in here. Again, Vayne with the CS, trying to do what she can. As we are going into overtime now.
All right, so the pink wards are being found. Hopefully they find that one as well.
Walk through the bush, didn't take it out. Again, that's why you always gotta be looking on yourself when you walk through jungle. If you can see what's gonna happen, you can always figure it out. Vayne, though, gonna get that CS up. Now has that Phantom Dancer. So if she does get into a 1v1 with anybody, she might have a chance, especially against Darius, depending on how well she does a Condemn. Gonna get dunked as they move on toward the rest of blue side. Ult comes up there, but a big Malphite ult to interrupt them, but Soraka is going down. Again, Mr. Spooky still alive. He's gonna get taken down. Flash missed by Malphite. And again, that is a 4-0. What does red side want to do? They have a little bit of a minion wave forming up in top.
They're heading towards Baron
and then push in through top. Looks like Vel'Koz still gonna try and stop something. I don't know what he can do. He does have Life Orb disintegration ray, but at the moment, I don't think he's gonna be able to kill anyone. Darius did teleport, go back to base.
Yep, that might be some disrespect there.
But Xerath, with the zone, it don't matter.
All right, so let's see what they can do here. They got a big wave pop. They got something there in mid.
Big damage comes out though by Vel'Koz. Wow. Gonna pick up the kill on Ashe.
Might not be in a good spot though.
And an unfortunate misclick, I think, by Braum there, trying to save Ashe with the Targons. Did not happen. Ended up using it on, she says, Wani.
So the initial use of this Baron is everyone's gonna empowered recall back because they're all very low from that Baron take.
All right, let's see how this is gonna play out right now. As Mr. Spooky gonna farm up a bit more again. Looking to be the main hope of his team, but he ended up getting caught out there and that really hurted him.
I'm really enjoying Team 2's ward coverage. I mean, this is the reason why they're able to make such a hit.
Vel'Koz looking to get that blue buff there. Vayne, not in a good spot. Just gonna avoid the tip there.
All right.
Is gonna get hit by that and has to back off. Again, just the sticking potential right now is just ridiculous. Here comes the ultimate from Ashe, just a little late. But again, look at this. This push down and bot. And with that Rift Herald buff, you just shred the turret as Darius is gonna pick up another kill. Four turrets for T2.
Yeah, you see how Malphite is ignored by Darius there as he just goes to hit that turret. They're gonna continue this push.
Alright, as we go in right now, Volibear trying to do what he can, but it's not looking too good right now. Silence Field goes down. We try and help him, but Ashe onto that turret, gonna take it out. Again, here we go. Ult's coming through. Volibear gonna get stunned up there. Again, kill comes out onto Ashe. Kill goes over to Xerath. He's gonna try and siege into that mid lane.
And I mean, Malphite can't really do anything
and
against
look
this
at
Darius.
That. That's just two auto attacks. It's the empowered through the rip shield and empowered your W, and it just shreds turrets when you have two Mountain Drakes.
Yeah.
Now, the third Mountain Drake will be spawning in a minute 10.
Let's see how much priority each team is going to place on it, because GDADS does not want...
think at this point, if you give up that Mountain Drake,
that's it.
You lose. I don't think there's a way of coming back from it at this point.
Then they'd have to win every single team fight from there on, otherwise it's just going to push into their base.
Meanwhile, Xerath now sitting at that 8-0-9, doing work for his team. See how well this ends up playing right now. 31 minutes on the clock. 11-23, T2 with the advantage.
All right, Darius is electing to go top lane because he does have the teleport to join his team when this dragon spawns. It's going to be about 30 seconds when it does. And red team already has the wards placed. They even have it placed in the Baron Pit if they don't need to.
Yeah. Again, the ward coverage is just everywhere on the map if you take a look at it.
Oh my goodness. 10 seconds left for that dragon, and Sejuani is already in place.
Yeah, red side really moving over there.
Vayne placing a ward down.
Vayne gotta be careful there. He's gonna come over the wall straight onto her.
And with
here we go. Mountain Drake is aggroed. And they can't really do much. They're going to have to give it up. And this is going to be one hell of a way to have to try and come back from. As they get the third Mountain Drake.
Yeah, GDADS already knew that they were going to lose that dragon because Volibear was in the top lane with Darius.
Here comes Volibear trying to come over here. But again, Darius, he's so big at the moment, he might be able to take them. Again, getting the stacks onto Malphite, looking to try and finish him off. It doesn't matter, but he gets the stacks onto Volibear. He's trying to maintain. It's a 5v1 right now. He's trying. Big ult comes out from Sejuani. He's still alive. And here we go. They're keeping going. Here comes Vayne. Vayne trying to do it. He ends up getting hooked by Darius. Darius not able to finish her off. There's Sejuani. Again, the witch comes out. Vayne kiting. It doesn't matter. Going to go down to Darius. And there's Soraka try and pick it up.
And the whole time, Ash was in the bot lane and she's going to continue to push. This is an inhib after a team fight win.
All right, here we go. 11-26. They can just end it at this point. They're trying their best.
And Ash is still unsupervised there. She's going to push it to the next turn.
She's just going to push it in. There's nothing that GDADS can do at this point.
All right, so yeah, she has to back up. They were pinging the middle inhibitor.
Yeah, and it looks like they're going for it. Inhib. They're just going to push in all the lanes at this point and just take a triple inhib.
Blue team's inhibitor has been destroyed.
Yeah, they can afford to back right after this if they wanted to.
Volibear's still going to try and make something happen. Xerath not able to connect on the Q, and that's all three towers, inner towers, inhib towers, going down for GDADS. Baron up in a minute 50. Honestly, though, they don't even need it at this point. Again,
Mountain Drakes were just so strong.
Yeah, the Mountain Drakes just tear through everything if you leave them unsupervised. They're going to try and see what they can make happen. 50k to 65k, 15k gold lead for T2. Let's see what they can do. All right, so as we're seeing here right now, blue side doing their best to defend, and it looks like red side is all exiting the base at the moment, gonna work their way up. As they go in onto the base at the moment right now, again, two inhibs down, one exposed. Vayne trying to clear out the waves as best she can, but here comes Xerath. Here comes everyone. A lot of damage coming down. Not a whole lot you can do as a Malphite at this point. 11-26. See what they can do. Again, all they really need to do is just go for an end at this point. 30 seconds on Baron. And they are starting to make their way up to there in the ward bush. Here they go. Red side pushing in. They want to take this inhib. They want to take this match. Let's see how it goes. Again, Zareth gets the poke down. Here we go, red side moving on in. Volibear gonna get stunned up here. He's gonna get knocked up. CC Chain is coming through. Here comes the dunk. One kill for Darius. Again, Vayne still alive. Double kill for Darius. Again, he's trying to make what he can happen. Triple kill. It's gonna get interrupted though by Ash there, taking the Quadra away. That should be the game. Red side pushing onto the base. They're your champions for this year's Edmonton Comics Entertainment Expo tourney here on Saturday. Here we go. Next is gonna fall for good measure. There's another one. Sejuani gonna finish it off. And there's your ace. 31-11. T2 takes the match. And with that, guys, we are done for today. We will be back tomorrow with our CSGO tourney. We'd like to thank everyone here at the Expo for letting us stay just a little late. And we'll see exactly how well this ends up going. Thank you guys for watching. We're going to go to intermission, and we'll see you tomorrow.